Hey everyone, my name is Mac Murdoch here with OPT and it's been raining outside. So in this video, we're inside where it's nice and dry and we're gonna be going over one of the most basic and essential steps when it comes to processing your images, stretching. When you first take your image, you might see something that looks like this, where your target is barely even visible, but hidden under all the darkness is the information you need to turn your image into this. Stretching is taking the histogram of your image and literally stretching it so that tiny sliver of data is scattered across the entire histogram, allowing you to see the shadows, midtones, and highlights that will eventually be in your final image. There are different ways to stretch an image and no way is right or wrong. We suggest you learn from a few people and find out which one works best for you. We're gonna keep it super basic in this video and show you how to stretch your image in 5 different programs. Deep Sky Stacker, Photoshop, PixInsight, Affinity, and GIMP. But if you wanna skip ahead to any of these specific programs, you can jump to these timestamps right here. All right, let's get started. So the very first step and most essential step to stacking your image is right below this video. You're gonna see a little thumbs up button. Hold your mouse over it until you see the sign says, I like this. And you wanna ever so gently, just single tap that button until it turns blue. After that, hit the subscribe button and ring the bell for notifications. So our first program is Deep Sky Stacker, which unfortunately only works for Windows, and this is a Mac. So luckily enough, I'm a wizard, so let's switch that out. All right, let's get into it. All right, so this is Deep Sky Stacker. So this is a perfect program to take all your calibration frames, like your light frames, dark frames, flat and bias, put them all into one program and have them spit out one image for you to start processing. I normally wouldn't stretch an image in Deep Sky Stacker because things like Photoshop or PixInsight gives you a lot more control and fine tuning. However, this is a perfect program to just be able to see what your image looks like after you've done stacking them. So, here is your histogram over here and your levels. And so I take the black slider over here and I move it until your data, which is this part over here, is as stretched out as you can. So like right about there looks good. And then you take your middle slider, your grays, and you move it until it's right above this curve over here, this curve. And then finally you take the white slider and you just kind of stretch things a little bit more. And then you click apply and you should see an image come up, and this is what the image looks like. All right, to save your image, you want to click this over here, save picture to file. Let's call it North American Nebula, here it is. And to apply the stretched image, you want to click apply adjustments to saved image over here. If you would just like the raw stacked image, you want to click this one over here. So let's click this one and let's click save. And that is how to stretch an image in Deep Sky Stacker. All right, so now that we're done with Deep Sky Stacker, I want to switch back over to my Mac. So, beepity bobbity floo! All right, well, let's get into Photoshop. All right, so here we are in Photoshop, and here's our unstretched image, and now it's time to stretch it. So let's go to image, you want to go to mode, and you just want to make sure that these settings are in its right spot. So if you're shooting in monochrome like I am, you want to make sure that you're in grayscale. If you're shooting a color image, you want to make sure that you're in RGB, and you want to make sure that you're editing in 16-bit. So the very first step that you want to do is go hit the like button if you haven't already. And then after that, come down to adjustments and you want to click levels. And here you can see that the data in this image is all the way off to the left. At that point, what we want to do is we want to bring it a little bit more to the center and start stretching it out. So to do that, you want to take this middle slider and move it closer to where our data is. And there you can see, you know, a little bit of our image, and you click OK. And so what we want to do next is go and just do it again. And the reason why we want to do it again is because now, as you can see, our data is closer to the middle. And every time that you repeat this process, it's like fine tuning your stretch. So we're going to move the black slider a little bit. And let's move this just a little bit as well. And maybe just the whites a tad, and then click OK. And let's do that one last time. So adjustments, levels. Something to keep in mind too is when you're moving the black slider, you don't want to move it over where your data is, like right about here. You don't want to do that because what you're doing now is you're doing what's called clipping, and you're actually losing valuable information. So let's back off that area just a little bit. Right about there seems good to me. And let's click OK. And there is your nicely stretched image in Photoshop. All right, let's head over to PixInsight. All right, so here we are in PixInsight. The very first thing we want to do is go to Process, and we want to open up two windows by going to Intensity Transformation, Screen Transfer Function. And let's leave that down there, and let's go to Process, Intensity Transformation again, and finally go to Histogram Transformation. So this first method is super simple on how to stretch your image and only done in like 2-3 steps. So this button over here is for an auto stretch. So you click it and here's our image auto stretched. And so the thing is it's not applied to the image yet. It's not applied to the histogram. It's just a preview of what it looks like. So in order to apply it, what we want to do is we want to click over here, which is the triangle, and click that and drag it to the bottom of this window. And you can see here that you have this nice curve going. And so at that point, you click this button over here to apply, click the square, and it's applied our changes. We see the white over here, and all we have to do is reset our histogram by clicking these reset buttons over here and one over here. And here's our image stretched out. Did it in 3 clicks. Sounds good to me. All right, so the other way to do it, let's open that up again, is to use, it's very similar to Photoshop in a way where you're moving the levels. So if you click the circle over here, this will give us a real-time preview of our changes that we're making. So here's our real-time preview. And so you want to move the middle slider over here, over on the left, and you should see your image start popping up just like that. Looks pretty good as it is. And then you want to click this button over here to apply. And just like last time, you do have to reset it because it is still showing the same changes that you were making before. So you click this button to reset. And so far that's looking pretty good. Let's do it one more time over here. Just a little bit, and maybe bring down the blacks. That's looking pretty good. And let's click apply. Let's reset. And then finally, let's just bring down the blacks. Yeah, so having that contrast really makes it pop. Maybe we'll bring up the whites. That's looking pretty good. All right, so let's apply, reset, and click out of here. And here is our nicely stretched image. This method gives you a little more control over how much you want to stretch it or what parts you want to stretch. You can also take both methods and just combine them. You can do the auto stretch and then do the fine adjustments using the histogram transformation. All right, so now that we're done with PixInsight, let's head over to Affinity. So here we are in Affinity, and over here on the right-hand side, you have all your tools like levels and gradient maps and your curves. And so today, for just this section, we're gonna deal with levels and curves. So first, let's head over to levels, click default, and we're gonna move this gamma slider off to the left until you start seeing your image. So far, that looks great. I'm gonna keep that about there. And we're gonna hit merge. And that saved that adjustment. Then we're gonna hit default again, and we're gonna start moving the black slider over, and we're also gonna hit it with the gamma. That looks good. Let's go black again. There you go. You start seeing a little more contrast in your image, and let's hit merge again. Let's do it one more time. So we're gonna hit default. That's gonna bring that up. Start bringing up this. Bring it with the blacks, maybe just a little bit more. There you go. So far that looks great. Now we're gonna hit merge, and then the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna head down to curves, and we're gonna hit default, and we're gonna give it a little bit of an S curve. So you wanna click down here, bring that down, and then we wanna bring the highlights up, give it a little more contrast, just like that. Hit merge, and there is stretching your image in Affinity. So the last one on our list is GIMP. GIMP is the only other free software besides Deep Sky Stacker, and this one is more geared towards editing. So let's jump on in. So here we are in GIMP, here's our image. And so the first thing we wanna do is go up to colors over here. You wanna hit at levels, and just like, you know, kind of the other programs, you wanna move the middle slider about there, looks good to me. You hit okay. Let's go colors again. Levels, and now you can move that black slider now that you've moved your data away from the left-hand side. Starting to come along, that looks good. Maybe let's move this just a little bit as well. That looks good. Click OK. Do it one more time. Levels, move the black slider. That looks pretty good to me right there. Let's click OK. We'll go color, and now we want to hit curves, and we're just going to do a basic S curve. So you bring the whites up and you bring the blacks down, and this just gives us a little more contrast in our image, helps us. Let's do it one last time. Curves, it's up, and bring this down. So that looks like a pretty good stretch to me. That's where I would keep it. And at this point, considering this is H alpha data, I would do the same thing with S2 data and O3 data, and then just take those three images and combine them for a full color image. So there you have it, everyone. You could see that there are a lot of similarities between the different techniques in each of the programs. And again, this is just one way of stretching your images. You can mix and match what you've learned in this video with other techniques to bring out the most out of your data. Let us know in the comments which program you use to process your data. In a future video, we'll dive a little bit deeper on more advanced ways of stretching and processing, like using star masks and setting your white and black points. Feel free to check out the link in the description below to download some free raw data for you to mess around with. If you guys like this video and found it helpful, please hit the like button, subscribe, and ring the bell for notifications. My name is Mac Murdoch here with OPT, and we'll see you in the next one. Clear skies.